on the floor and you can put your legs over the bolster, yeah? So ideally, we put the bolster or the pillow beneath your knees. So your feet are touching the floor, yeah? Okay, so when we lying down, nice and comfy, yeah? Okay, cool. Start just to settle there. If you find that extending the legs maybe is uncomfortable for your lower back, you can bend the legs, yeah, and put your feet on the floor. So without forcing, just start to check your body on the floor. Yeah? So start to settle. Yeah, so you check your bum, your hips, your lower back. Check if you can expand the back of the neck, your spine, without forcing, eh? Wherever you are in this moment. Relax your arms. Yeah, try to settle, expanding your body, but at the same time in a sweet, nice, gentle way. And then start to focus or on your breathing or on the sensation of your body. Okay, so you can focus the touch of the body on the floor and use that as a tool to go inside. Or you can use your breathing. Okay, so on the breathe out, surrender in each breath more and more to the floor. Yeah, so each breathe out, you fall more. It's like you want to become one with the floor, with the mat. And in that falling down, you are falling in as well. Yeah, we are bringing the attention inwards. Surrender. And as we keep relaxing toward the floor, imagine releasing now your roots from your body into the floor, or you can imagine as always the roots already there, waiting for you to connect or to reconnect. And imagine those roots going deeply into the planet, like a really inside, yeah, like a, to the very core or heart of the planet. Imagine that we are reaching for that untouched and pure energy. And now you can start to focus as well on the breathing. So when you breathe in, imagine that we are lifting that nice, warm energy. Let that energy move through your body, through your mind, through your heart. And then imagine that all your attention, stiffness, tightness, any pain, any discomfort, all the stress is leaving your body now through your breathe out. And it's going, all that is going into the roots. And the roots and the planet will recycle that for you. Yes, so it's two ways. You breathe in, you receive pure energy. You breathe out, you release your tension and your stress. And here is like we are practicing for during the day. You can do this. You don't have to even lying down on the floor. You can do it sitting or even standing. And just focus on your breath. And your brain and your body will train. So when you really focus on your breath, you will start to feel the benefit of the relaxation. It's like we train to think that when we breathe, we receive this. But we go even further. Yeah, imagine that when you receive that energy through your breath, imagine also that you receive a loving energy, a healing energy that is embracing you, is protecting you. And you can imagine when you breathe in that energy is overflowing your body, your heart, and is filling that cocoon that we always work, yeah, that cocoon around us. Yeah, so we feel our body, our mind, our heart, and that cocoon around to have that extra cushioning of energy and protection around us. Yeah, that extra loving hug around us. So when you have all that in place, yeah, the breathing, receiving and releasing. Yeah, you have your cocoon, you have the image of the roots. We will start to bring some little movements to your hands, to your feet, yeah, moving your fingers and your toes. We can move the head side to side. And then we can stretch your arms and expand. And then we bend the legs. You can keep the bolster or the pillows beneath your legs, or you can move it. And with the feet on the floor, we reconnect the lower back. Yeah, when you're bending the knees, you can put more of your lower back on the floor. So pushing with your lower back into the floor, lengthen your spine more, bring the chin toward the chest. Yeah, always this action of bringing the chin forward with your head pushing on the floor. Yeah, you don't lift the head just to put the chin there. And when you feel your back nice and connected, we bring one leg. We relax the leg toward your belly. When you catch the leg, check that you are not tense in your arms or your upper body. And then we open that knee out. We can catch the knee and the foot, or remember, you can always relax your arms on the side. So grounding, you keep relaxing your back to the floor. And then we stretch the leg up. We move the leg side to side. We want to use the leg also as a weight for your lower back to be more on the floor. We can do little circles. Good. And then we move the foot in circles. Nice and big, but in a soft rhythm. Doesn't have to be fast. Good. Well done. We relax, we catch the other leg. So soft. Relax your leg toward your belly, relax your shoulder blades and your arms. We open the knee to the side. And we're lifting the leg up and we move side to side. And then in circles. And then we move the foot in circles. Good. Very nice. Now we keep the leg on the up. Try to flex your foot, yeah? And we will go a little bit forward with your foot, the leg, like extending but soft, go all the way down toward the floor. We don't have to touch the floor. And then relax the leg. So we flex a foot, move the leg forward toward the floor, and then bend the leg. Soft, yeah? Now as you do that, try to connect your lower back toward the floor. agua mortal. And then we will put that leg over the other leg bending, and we bring both legs in this position. We soften side to side. We are working a little bit more in depth the lower back. So relax side to side. And we do a little bit of circles. This is for hips, yeah? One more time. Good. Now we change. We lift in the other leg. Flex the foot, yes, so the toes point in your face. And we go with the heel far away, trying to keep the lower back on the floor. We don't have to touch the floor. We hover over the floor. And then we keep moving. Yes, so this is really good for lower back, but that also for the hips. We are doing gently. Gently, and you keep the lower back on the floor. So we do two more. And we do one more. And then we put that leg over the other leg, and with both legs bending, we catch the first leg and we move side to side. Remember, the head is always on the floor and the chin toward the chest. We want to use always in these positions the weight of your body to help lengthen the back of the neck. That is the part that most suffer during the day, yeah? For the position that we are now with the phones and the tablets and all that. We roll. Well done. And we bend both legs and we go side to side. Good. And we roll toward one side and we go to all fours. Good. Very nice. So if you can already have your bolster or your pillow in front of you, we will use it as a helper for the next pose. Yeah? So we will move in circles now the hips. Remember, when we do this, the shoulders are already rolling back. Yeah, so you are not tensing your shoulder. Remember, relax the shoulders away. Move the hips in circles there, and then the opposite direction. Open your fingers. Yeah. Good. And then on the center, breathing, open arching the spine, shoulders roll back, lifting the head and the bum is out. We stay a little bit in this arching position without tensing, without forcing, yeah? And when you breathe out, we lift in the spine, we round the back, the head and the neck releasing down. So breathing, expanding open, breathe out, rounding, breathing, expanding open, breathe out, rounding, and one more time. Good. We will open the knees and we will go back with the hips, yeah? So here, you go first with the hips and then don't rush to go to the floor. Start like a releasing your belly between the legs, then your solar plexus, and then your chest and your head. Open your arms and soften. Use the breathe out to surrender to the floor. This position is ideal to release. Yes, so focus here on the breathe out and imagine surrendering all the tension that you are discovering now on your hips, on your lower back. Whatever is tension now, imagine that with your breath out, you are let it go. We move the hands to one side. And remember that you're breathing through the roots. You are releasing. And you are receiving on the breathing new energy, fresh, pure, to replace the one that you are leaving. Let it go. We go to the other side. And you can always imagine that cocoon around you, helping you to release even more and to feel safe and secure as you do it. Well done. Now we're coming back to the center. We put the bolster on the front or the pillows. It's just to create a little bit of elevation for your hands. Yeah. So we put the hands there. We keep the position and we soften again. Bone back. Belly toward the legs and then solar plexus and then your chest. We want to create that extra opening on the chest. Soften the shoulder blades. And then relax. We go to all fours and we bring the one arm beneath the other arm. Here we put the shoulder on the floor. We put the head. When you put the head, check that you can create a little bit more space between your shoulder and your ear here to expand the neck. And the other arm comfortable on the front or on the diagonal. And soften, yes. So you let go your chest on the arm that is beneath you. Let go, release. You are letting go all the tension that you carry on those shoulders, on the neck. And then coming back. We go to the other side. So we soften and relax. And then release. Well done. We go again to all fours and we will work a little bit more on the legs. Yeah? So again, relax your shoulders away. Yeah, that rolling back of the shoulders. We expand one leg back. We open an arch but soft and then rounding. Yeah? So you want to create those two movements. One that is open and arch and the other one round. Breathing on the opening. Breathe out on the rounding. And we do one more. Breathing on the opening and rounding. Well done. One more time. And then we go with the other leg. Breathing, expanding and rounding. Breathing open one more time. Go and last one. Very nice. Well done. And now we will go to put one leg forward just for a moment, yeah? The last one on the knees, okay? Promise. If you need, you put the pillow there. So we want to bring the hip forward here. It's just to work a little bit on the opening of the hip on the front. Yeah? So move the hip forward. Yeah? Relax your shoulders. Lifting the solar plexus and the chest and lifting your arms softly. not forcing, not tensing, whatever is possible for you. We don't have to have the hands here. We can have the open arms to release the tension here. Yeah, just for a moment. Let the bum and the hips go forward. Yeah, open here. Not forcing, just using the breath out softly. Yeah. And then relax. Well done. We will change. Yeah, we will put the other leg. Good. And we do the same just for a moment. So relax. Open, not forcing. Soften. Yeah, use your breath out to surrender in this position to the floor. And when you are settled, lifting solar plexus and chest, open your arms through the side and you go up wherever you can move the hands without forcing your shoulders. We focus on the idea of receiving when you breathe in and breathe out and letting go. Good, and then relax. Well done. Very nice. So from there, we will sit on the floor, yeah? So we'll do a little bit of hips before we go to our first restorative, yeah? So here you can choose to sit in or on the floor or maybe above the pillows, yeah? Not too high, yeah? So more or less on the floor. If you find it difficult with the knees, we open. Yeah, at any point, don't worry. So what we will try to do here, I show you from the side, is pushing into the hips to open chest and solar plexus, yeah? So on the breathe out, like we did on the on all fours, on the breathe out we round, on the breathe in we lift in and we open. A few times, yeah? Now as you do that, check that you are not lifting the shoulders, that you are not tensing here on the upper body. Yeah. So the only part that it feels strong is the pushing of the hips and the solar plexus opening. The shoulders and the arms relax. Yeah. One more time. This action is helped to find awareness on this area. So during the day, we don't hold tension and we build the tension and then we have pain. Yeah. One more time. Open. And check, because when you open here, you tense this, relax. Yeah, good. Last one. Now, keeping that nice open, we open the arms. Check that you didn't lift the shoulders. Yeah? And we go up wherever is possible. You keep pushing with the hips, and we expand the sides here. So imagine that you are using the hip as like a foot. Yeah, like you are grounding on the hip to expand the side, but it's not tensing, it's soft, yeah? It's really soft that you feel the stretch, but it's not a painful stretch, yeah? Well done, very nice. And we relax, we soften. So we'll put the hands behind with the shoulders rotated, pushing again against the floor with your hips, open solar plexus and chest. Lifting the chin a little bit, but not too much that is painful on the neck. Good. And then we relax and we will place the hands on the front. Now, again, if you need to open the legs, open. Yeah? The same idea. When you put the hands, check that you are pushing into the hips and you open the solar plexus, yeah? So you move forward just a little. We don't have to go all the way and force it. Just moving, yeah? We are working on the hip here, yeah? And obviously the lower back in a safe position. So chest is open. We don't lead with the head, yeah? We lead with the chest and the shoulders are relaxing. Very nice, well done. Now, if you can, the last one, yeah? We change the leg, yes? Yeah? So we put the other leg forward. If you open the legs, you repeat the exercise with the legs open. So again, you're pushing into the hips, put the hands behind, shoulders back, open your chest. Open solar plexus chest, lifting the chin a tiny bit and pushing into the hips. Imagine that with your hips, with that pushing, with that grounding, you command the energy that is coming up from the planet, yeah? And imagine that the energy is passing through from the pelvic floor through the spine toward the crown of your head, yeah? We are incorporating now the idea of the chakra. So imagine that all that energy is passing through the line of the chakras, cleansing, pushing out the whatever is blocking it, so you can have a nice flow of energy through the chakra system. And then relax. Again, we put the hands forward, pushing with the hips, chest, shoulders back, and hands. Doesn't matter, it's just a little bit. Yeah. We want to flex the hips and with the knees open. Yeah. Good. Well done, well done. Chest up. Yeah. Very nice. Now we look up and nice and gentle. Again, pushing into the hips. We will rotate. Promise after we do nice restorative. Yeah? We will rotate slowly. Open chest, shoulders away. The same idea. Yeah. So you push into the hips to lifting your body up. The chest is open, your shoulders are always relaxing, and you move wherever is possible. Always keep a little bit of the belly in, not all the way that you can breathe, a little bit of connection there. So it's like you offer more support for the lower back as you twist in the position. And then relax. We move to the other side. So pushing into the hips, lifting chest, shoulders away. We move slowly. And coming back, well done. We do the last one, open arms, expanding. And we'll release. Well done. Very nice. So we will move a little bit the shoulders here. Yeah? We will do a little bit of touch for the neck and we go to our restorative one. Yeah? So shoulders away. Soft, yeah? And even softer if you are really tight. Yeah? Don't go fast or strong. Soft, really sweet. And in the next time that you roll the shoulders and you put the shoulders back, again, we're lifting the chest up and we will move the head to one side. Stay there. Check that you are pushing with the hips. Chest is open. Your shoulders are relaxing down. Coming back to the center. Push with the hips. We go to the other side. Chest is lifted, shoulders are soft. Coming back to the center, we do it one more time. Yes, so we move. Remember that if it's painful with the knees, we can open the legs. Eh? It's the same position, knees bending. Coming back, and we go to the other side. And release. And then we will roll the head side, forward, and side, but in a really gentle and slow movement. Yeah. So start with the chin to the chest, the legs open or bending. We move to one side, relaxing on the breathe out, breathing on the side. Relaxing on the breathe out, forward. Yeah. Keep the pushing of the hips into the floor and the chest lifted. So we're really working on the neck. And the last one, last one, last one. Well done. Very nice. Good. So we will go to our first restorative with the bolster to child pose position, okay? So if you have the knees that are not okay in this position, you can put a blanket beneath, or if at any point it's too much, you can lying down on the bolster, yeah? So remember we put the bolster on the front between the knees, yeah? So we don't sit on the pillow or the bolster, yeah? We will go to child pose. If the bolster is too low, we want to have all the belly and the chest and the head on the bolster supported, yeah? So remember, if you feel that it's too low, you put an extra cushion or a block or a blanket there, yeah? So the same always, you go with the hips. If you need, you can put a blanket on the top, yeah? So hip back, belly between the legs, and then you try to put belly, chest, and one cheek. Then we will rotate it and we put the other cheek. Once you are there, relax your shoulders away and soften your body to the floor. Now, with all the movements that we did on the warming up, probably you notice where is the tension in your body, where are the spots that you need to release the most, yeah? So imagine now that each breath out, you are giving permission to your body to release all those spots of tension. And imagine that when you breathe in, you are receiving that pure energy from the planet that goes even further in those spots on the body to melt the tension, to release the pain. So imagine on the breathing, you receive that healing, warm energy to release the tension. And on the breathe out, you let go, you release, you surrender. Each breath. Imagine all around you that beautiful cocoon with that loving, protective energy all around you. And as you relax the physical tension, remember that also you are releasing the emotional tension, the stress, the worries, concerns, fears. So imagine that you are being purified completely, mind, body, and soul. With each breath in, you are receiving that cleansing, healing energy that moves through you, and on the breath out, you let go, you surrender. Slowly, really slowly, we will move the head to the other side and we put the other cheek. Give a little bit of time to feel comfortable again in that side. And again, keep relaxing, keep surrendering. Keep imagining that cocoon around you. And now imagine that from really high above, you are receiving now like a ray of violet light that is bathing the cocoon that you are in and is passing through. Violet light is the color of the seventh chakra, the crown chakra, and is the color of transformation, transmutation. So it's a powerful light and color that allows you to have like a really deep cleanse. Again, not only physical, emotional as well. Yes, so imagine that you receive that bathing light of deep cleansing. And also is the crown chakra, the color violet is the color of connection. Yes, so imagine that you are receiving like a universal hug of love as well. Connection, the idea that we are all connected, that we are all one. So imagine that like a net or web of energy that connects us all. And that's the light that is bathing you now. Good. Now really slowly, using your hands as a support on the floor, we will lift it. The chest, the head from the bolster. And if your bolster is flat, you put now a block or a pillow or a cushion. So you have this diagonal shape, yeah? And we will turn around and we will lie down over the bolster. Now, remember the hips are on the floor and touching the bolsters or the pillow. So you want the same idea. You want all the back from the hip to the back of the head on the bolster, yeah? The legs could be bending, could be crossing, could be extending, yeah? You can have your blanket as well, yeah? Now, in the child pose, we let go, we release. Now we will absorb. Yeah, so take your time to go into the bolster. Yeah, find a comfortable position there. If you notice that the lower back is not comfortable, you put an extra cushion in beneath your bum. Yeah, so you want comfort, you want peace there, so you can focus on the receiving. Yeah, so. Once you find the position there, take another moment to push with the hips into the floor and move your spine. So check that you are really long on the bolster. Even bring your chin a little bit to the chest to lengthen the back of the neck. And then expand your arms. Nice and comfy. And you want to feel the chest open here, yeah, the solar plexus open, yeah, cool. Take a moment, yeah, could be that it's not super comfortable, okay, when we have pain or ache, so slowly try to find your more comfortable place there and focus on the breathing for a moment, yeah, allowing your breath out to bring you more and more toward the bolster, toward the floor. We keep imagining that cocoon around us. We keep imagining that shower of violet light over, really high over the cocoon. Yeah, like a beautiful energy surround us completely and protecting us. Yeah, so in that safe place, we will start to receive all the energies through the chakras. Yeah, to have like an even deep cleanse and recharging. So as you breathe in, that you can imagine that you are receiving the energy from the planet through the roots. We will lift in from the planet a beautiful red light now. So imagine the roots absorbing from the very core of the planet a beautiful red light that is entering into your body, maybe from the legs and your hips, bathing like the pelvic floor, And then imagine passing through the whole body and then overflowing your body and filling your cocoon. Yeah. Red light is the color of the first chakra. Remember, is the chakra that manage our emotions and our beliefs related with our basic needs. Yeah. If we are provided, if we are safe, if we are healed, yeah, with health. So imagine that red light providing us with everything that we need on the physical aspect. So body, soul, heart, cocoon is all red. And then imagine we can leave the red there working at the same time. And we will focus now in the next breathing that we are lifting an orange light now, a beautiful shade of orange light coming up, going more specifically first to your lower back, your hips, your belly, all that area. And that is the chakra that manage our emotional body, our desires, our creativity force. So imagine that orange light bathing that chakra, all that area, and then filling our body, our heart, our mind, and the cocoon, providing us with that extra support that we need for our emotional body right now. And let the orange light work there. You still have your red light as well. And now we will receive from the planet a beautiful yellow light that will move directly into our solar plexus. Yes, through your middle back. And imagine that light working there. Solar plexus is a chakra of our power and energy. So imagine that we are receiving a recharging energy for our body, our mind. We are feeling the body, we are feeling the cocoon. And you let that light keep recharging you, body and soul. And you have your red, you have your orange, your yellow. And now we will lift from the planet a beautiful loving light in a shape of a pink light. That's the energy of unconditional love coming from our Mother Earth, going up into our heart. And this energy is overflowing our heart, bathing our body, bathing and filling our cocoon. Receiving like a big hug of loving energy, a huge hug. And you let the pink light work for you there. And then we will receive from the planet a beautiful turquoise light. And imagine that light goes into your neck, into the base of your shoulders, or that area that we typically have pain. And imagine inside in your throat. Yeah? This light is working in our chakra of communication and expression. So imagine this beautiful turquoise light, pure, like the sky in the really bright morning. And that light is cleansing our chakra there, allowing us to be able to express and communicate our needs and everything that our creativity force as well is expressed also through the throat chakra. So imagine that light there. And then we will receive like an indigo color or royal blue color, and that goes into the middle of your forehead between your eyes, and that's what we call the eye, the third eye, and it's the area that connects us with our intuition, our wisdom. We have all the answers that we need inside, just we need to trust that we are wise and we can listen to our intuition. So imagine that area there being open, the feeling of trust in yourself being expanded, enhanced. And then we keep imagining that violet light from really high above, with that deep cleansing and that deep feeling that we are all connected and together, even in this situation. So imagine now all those colors working there in harmony, dancing around your body inside the cocoon. And imagine they forming like a rainbow of colors, dancing in harmony, cleansing and healing and recharging. And then imagine that at some point, this rainbow is transformed in a really powerful white, pure white light that is filling that cocoon and is passing through your body. And this white light is purifying even deeper. As you are protected through the white violet light around you. So your cocoon is white, the violet light is forming a big, thick wall around your cocoon, protecting that white light. That is a combination of all the color of the chakras. So you have all the lights and the power there that you need, and that will remain with you inside your cocoon, even when we finish this class. So remind yourself of that. You have everything that you need there. So you connect, you reconnect with yourself whenever you need it during your day, through your breath. And then take a nice deep breath, visualizing the cocoon, your body inside, the lights. And then slowly, really gentle, bring your hands wherever you feel is the right spot for you. Could be your heart, could be your belly, or any other part of your body. And imagine that you save there, like an anchor in like a gate, a door, a window. So whenever you touch that area again, you are being reminded of that power that you have inside to connect with the light and the energy that you need in each moment. And you are anchoring that image of the rainbows and the white light and the violet light. And then slowly we can expand the legs, we can expand the arms, take like a soft, gentle stretch. And then slowly, slowly we will fold toward one side, bending your knees. We can place the hands above your arms. And slowly, slowly we will go to sitting position. We will take the bolster now. We will lie down on the back, but have the bolster or the pillow or a block or a blanket roll. Yeah. So we will lie down, yeah, with your knees bending. We flat here the back. Yeah. So first, take a moment, have the cushion or the block beside your hand, but don't rush and put it beneath your hips. Take a moment here to spread first. Yeah, you can keep your blanket if you want above you, Also, the working with the blanket above you in this position, even if you are not cold, is allowing you to have that idea of that you have a cocoon over you. Yeah, that's why I'm using as well the blanket. So once you feel that you are nice and comfy, you lift the hips and you put your block or your pillow beneath your hips, yeah, on the lower back. So more on the sacrum, yeah, the triangular bone that you have between the hips. And then allow your body there to relax. Your chin toward the chest, yeah? So we want the back of the neck toward the floor. And allow your arms to spread. This is a beautiful position for the front of the hips, for your lower back, for your neck, for your shoulders. Yeah? So take a moment to lengthen the neck, the back of the neck, and spread your shoulder blades. Expand your arms so you can bring the shoulders away from your ears in this position. And the weight of your body is helping you to expand all those muscles, yeah, to feel more stretchy and less pain. On the emotional aspect, we are giving an extra support for your second chakra, yeah, the emotional body area. So imagine that we are receiving that extra support that we need. Imagine that from the block or the cushion, you receive that energy, loving energy of the planet, that support. And still you have the cocoon around you. Yeah, all the lights working there for you. So you just relax and let all these powerful energies and lights work for you. You don't have to focus. You can just relax and let the energies work for you. Or if you feel the need that you want to focus in one in particular, you can imagine that particular light coming from beneath and inside the cocoon. Yeah, feeling your body and your soul completely. And just let go, relax, surrender. Slowly, as you keep relaxing in this position, you can choose here. Maybe you want to stretch your legs forward to expand more your hips. That's one option. Or maybe you want to lift in the legs up with the legs comfy and bending, yeah? So depending the feeling of the front of your hips, you choose, yeah? Both positions are bringing benefit to your hips, to your lower back, yeah? So you relax on the position that you choose, not forcing, not tensing, yeah? Whether you have the legs forward or the legs up, are comfy, the knees are bending, yeah? Your feet are soft. There is no tension here. Just allow your body to surrender. Using each breath out to let go more deeply to the floor. Keep bringing the chin toward the chest so you expand the back of your neck. And then slowly, really slowly, taking your time, we come back to bending the legs, putting the feet on the floor. Softly, we take the block out with your cushion. And then slowly we bring the thighs to your belly. We move side to side. And we bring the knees toward one side to a spinal twist. Your arms are nice and open. Your shoulders are relaxed. Surrender deeply there. And imagine this pose like a really big gesture of trust that you are supported, that you are minded, that you are protected, and that you are receiving everything that you need, all the energy and all the loving energy that you need. And then slowly, slowly, we move to the other side, taking your time. Surrender deeply. No big movement, just slow, gentle, taking your time to feel that you are really allowing yourself to receive. Yeah, so no tension here. And then slowly we will move to the center and we go to Shavasana. Yeah? So nice and comfy, legs comfy, open, your arms open. You can place again if you like your pillows beneath your knees. Yeah? So super comfy. If you need pillows beneath the head, your blanket. Yeah? So find your more comfortable position. Put your blanket on, your socks. And start to open your body on the floor again. Take a moment to focus on the physical aspect first, you're feeling the lower back, your spine, your neck, your arms, your legs. And then again, start to focus on your breathing. Remember your roots connecting you with the energy of the planet, receiving that pure energy from the very heart of the planet. And from above, that violet light is still there, showering your cocoon, strengthening that cocoon, yeah, that filter around you. And with each breath, you are receiving more and more energy of relaxation and peace through the roots. And we will receive another extra flow of energy that will enter into yourself through your feet. Yeah? So this energy will increase even further that relaxation, that peace, that comfort. So imagine that energy on your heels, moving through the sole of your feet, your toes, the sole of your feet and the top of your feet, your ankles, your lower legs, your knees, your thighs and your hips, your lower back, middle back, upper back, shoulder blades, your shoulders, your arms, your hands, your fingers, your wrists, your elbows, your shoulders, the back of your neck, the back of your head, the crown of your head and your face, your neck, your chest, your belly, allowing your body to surrender completely to the floor and going deeply inside now and relax, relax, relax. Now slowly, really slowly, allow your awareness to get back to your body and start to bring some movements to your hands, to your feet, moving your fingers, your toes, moving your head side to side, and you can bring your arms to the side or back and expand, and from there we go to one side, bending your knees, and we go to a sitting position, crossing your legs and breathing deeply. Now give a big thanks to yourself for taking the time to come to class today. And I thank you for sharing your time and your practice with me. Thank you.